What's up, everybody? Welcome back. It is day 15, and I skipped a day. If you looked yesterday, there was no video. I actually recorded quite a bit of my kids playing outside, a bird's nest that I found outside that creeps me out because I hate birds. I'm definitely afraid of them, and there's one littered in my backyard. But I didn't get a chance to post it. I watched Game of Thrones, and man, I was exhausted. I actually fell asleep for 10 minutes in it and had to go back and rewatch it. So that's what I want to talk about today. I want to talk about the keto flu and the resurgence of that when you knock yourself out of ketosis. So a few nights ago, some of our best friends came over and we had dinner with all of them. We did a charcuterie plate, and I tried to be really responsible and eat things that were in my diet. So there were lots of cheeses, there were some smoked salmon and things that were totally fine for me to eat. But I think I overdid it. I definitely had a glass too much of wine, which added too many carbs, and I had too many calories for sure. And I'm pretty convinced I knocked myself out of ketosis because I woke up yesterday and I felt groggy, but I just kind of attributed that to the wine and the day before. But man, by midday, I was exhausted. My wife wanted me to go take a walk with her, and I did, and I felt terrible the whole time. And then by the time Game of Thrones came on, I just needed to go to bed. I woke up today still feeling really, really tired, which tells me either I'm coming down with a sickness, which is doubtful, although this allergy season definitely has my throat feeling kind of awful every day, or more likely I knocked myself out of ketosis and I got to get myself back into it. So the downside is I know how today is going to go, which means a fast heart rate, which means sweating a little extra, which means being a little bit groggy. So as I head to work for a closing shift, I know by the end of it I'm going to be tuckered out. But the good news is I won't be home to make any eating mistakes, so I can really be smart about what I put in my body today. And, you know, for me, this is an important thing if you're on this journey to know is that you're going to mess up. You're going to have days that aren't perfect. And it's not like I went and had 10 French fries and knocked myself out that way. I just wasn't as disciplined as I normally am. And that's okay. When you have those, it's about getting back up and going back through it so you can get back to where you want to be. Because I got a long way left in this journey. I've got more than half of what I initially wanted to lose left to lose. So I've got some more weight loss to do. I've got some more physical health to do. My mind is much more open and less foggy when I'm on this diet. So I know how important it is for me to stay here. But I wanted to give you encouragement if you're going down this road and you've slipped and you fell, that you can get back up, and all of us do, and it's okay, because that's the best is when we get back up and we do better than we did last time. So I'll talk to you tomorrow.